That's cool, man. I like it.
I do ask for a tip for photos or videos, anything you can help me out with. Okay.
So the debate is on, which pair of shoes do I wear for my first cross-country race in, I don't even know how long, several years. Forgive the mess, just did laundry. That's all clean, by the way, all right? And then those are a bunch of Hot Wheels stuff that I had since I was a kid, and I just went through a reminiscent phase, so ignore that too. I bring all three pairs, make a better decision when I'm there. And see the course. So first we have the Brooks Pure Flow 4s, which I've had for, I don't know, about 8 months or so. They're pretty worn out. Used them for triathlon as well, off-roading, everything. Great shoes. I did my ultra marathon in them. Great shoes. I love them, but they're pretty old. I trust them. I've had a lot of good runs in them. I did my fast 3-mile tempo in them as well, so I know they can handle the speed. These are my newer shoes, the Asics Dynaflight 2s. I don't like Asics. I used to like Asics, don't like them anymore. And they remind me too much of Ryan Hall. But they really, I don't know, they're okay. Weight-wise, they're about the same as the Brooks. They don't feel quite like wearing them barefoot like I do most of my shoes. My feet are not used to them yet, so my heels get cut up. The Asics just feel a little bit bulkier. They're okay. And then these are the oldest shoes actually out of the three, but the least amount used. These are Nike track spikes, rubber spikes. I use these in my famous sub 10 2-mile video. That was like 2013, I think. All right, so the advantage is those are light. Maybe about close to 4 ounces lighter than the other two pairs, 3 or 4 ounces. But they're not very comfortable, which I don't care about, but when I think about a 10K race, it's long enough where I don't know if I can handle something that minimal for that distance. The longest I've done a 5K in them, but it was on the track. Nothing on road. I don't know. I ran them today, and this is my foot right here. Big gash. When you run in shoes that are drastically different, something you're not used to, you have to consider your form changes. I might run with better form, better midfoot form than I would normally, but if I'm not used to it and I'm running at race paces, any difference in form is really going to be exaggerated over that distance and that pace. I'm going to feel it a lot, and my muscles be very tight. My feet are going to be, you know, beat up. So I don't know. I'm going to check the course out and make my determination. You know, every race is different. You should have multiple pairs of shoes for all different events.
Chris! Hey. Come on, Frankie. Tres, tres, atrás de ti.
Yeah, Chris!
Ow, ow!
Yeah, Chris! Looking good, honey. All right, and there it is.
That was a very hard course. But I knew after like two laps, I saw my switch and I knew, like I said before, don't worry about time.
Yeah.
I pretty much stayed with the same guys.
Yeah, and you overtook a couple.
They kind of like, we were kind of like round robin a little bit.
Yeah.
But in the end, I was like, oh, well, to get to the last downhill, I'll try to pass someone. Well, everyone had that strategy. So everyone picked it up, and I couldn't catch anybody. You know, after you graduate, you don't do cross country. You always do the road races.
Yeah.
And it spoils you. It pampers you.
Putting in the...
This, like, first of all, having to worry every lap uphill the whole way. So basically, you wouldn't have a heart attack, and you go, okay, I'll recover in the downhill. But you don't really recover, you just speed up because of the, you keep your cadence going, otherwise you're right. Wasting energy. So you end up keeping your heart rate up.
And it's loose gravel too on the way down.
Yeah, it's a lot of loose, like finding the right path. And you have like a couple times, like going even uphill, I felt my footing kind of go like that because you're so tired, but you have to worry about your steps.
Basically, after the race, my family that was watching, everyone that came to watch, they're like, okay, we're hungry. You didn't get an award, right? Can we go to breakfast? I was like, yeah. Basically, there's cash prize for first, and I know that top 10 got something, but outside of that, there wasn't anything. There was no participation medal or anything. So I don't have the official results yet, but I was within one or two places. I think I was 21st. I may have been 20th, but I think I was 21st place. So I did okay. I mean, it's one of those races where, so I ran my official time, I think in the race was like maybe 36:53, 36:54, something like that. Now, it was a little bit long. It was 6.28 miles. So I was really like a mid 36. 36:25, I think, was when I hit 10K. And that's slow. I'm not, you know, I don't really care about time on that kind of course. But to get a sense of perspective, I looked up the guy who won, because all the Strava data is online now. So the guy who won ran a high 32. So he beat him by 4 minutes, and his PR is 30:02 or 30:01. So he was 2.5 minutes. If you take off the extra distance, so I was mid 36, he was mid 32. That's 2.5 minutes off his PR. Then another guy that was closer to me, about 20 seconds ahead, kind of in the right before that pack that you saw at the end before I came in. There was a guy in the pack that was 20 seconds ahead of me. His PR is high 33s. So 20 seconds ahead of me, high 33s, that's a low 34. So, I mean, I think that the course was anywhere from 2 to 2.5 minutes slower than your PR, based on, depends on the runner, you know, how good you are at cross country and whatnot. So it was very challenging, but it's one of those races where I can't say, oh, I ran a slow time, but I finished well in the race, like a good place. Oh, it was a hard course, but I won. Can't say that. And then it wasn't a fast competitive course where I can go be like, oh, well, I didn't finish very high, but I PR'd. I can't say I PR'd or ran a fast time. Can't say I placed well, just blah. But even though I was really close to those guys at the end, and I kept telling myself, come on, toughen up, catch them, you know, have a kick at the end. I think I was only sprinting like a 5:20 something pace at the end. I had nothing left. And it was a slight uphill into the finish. But I looked at my heart rate data, and even though my heart rate on my watch wasn't working the first 4 miles, after that it was working. And it shot up on the Strava graph. You could see it after about mile 4 until the end, so 6.3. The last 2.3 miles where my heart rate data was registering, I averaged 185 beats a minute. So it's reasonable to assume most of the race was that high. And then my max was 190, which is the highest max I've ever had. I've hit 190 before, maybe like two other times, but definitely that is my max. Even though you tell yourself, oh, I could have picked it up a little harder, or I should have caught that guy or stayed with him. You know what? I think I can rest assured that I gave it my all, because my heart rate data, 190 beats a minute. I mean, I could not push any harder. So, it, you know, there's turkey trots coming up on Thursday, like the one when I won over $100 last year doing the 5 and 10K double. I don't know if I'm gonna do that again. We'll see if I'm recovered by then.